Good evening, welcome to .programming.blogspot.com. Today we will learn how to design command box in ASP.NET. Then we simple design, first of all design a database. And now add the database into the application data folder. Add new item. Because application data folder provide the inbuilt security. It does not directly open under the browser, take some times. The studio is storing, not responding. You can use the Visual Studio 2010 also. Okay, AI is created here. I can new table designing the command table in your data connection and your service explorer. Add in new table. ID is already created. Write the table name here, that is the command table, and ID is already here. Now if you want to add a new attribute into the table, then wait for some times, otherwise use this comma and write the column name here. Name, the type of the data is variable type character, which is size is 50. Email is maximum. Name, email, website. Website name is content into the 50. Oops. Okay. Now we can increase the 100 size and the content. The content takes maximum size. Also, set the isIdentity property to true. Is the property the identification is identity is by default false, so set to true and save this table using the update key. Yeah, that is the first table is created into the server explorer. Okay, now close it. Table is a comment and this attribute is shown below: name, email, website and content. Now add a new page, add new item, web form, feedback. Open design window and add some tools from the toolbox, like the table control, HTML table control. Add some controls like the name, email, website, and fourth one is content. Add new row. Content. Okay, add some controls from the standard tab, text box, increase the size, copy it and paste it here. Also change the name of the text box, that is the name text box. So ID is a name text. Email text box. So change the name of email text box. and website is a website text, web text, and the content is the content text. Okay, add another row below and add the submit button here. Comment now. Add the repeater control from the data tab, because the repeater control display the list of the items onto the page. Also add some validations from validations tab, like the name is required for required validator, required field validator control, email also required field validator control, website is not mandatory, and content is always required. Change the property of the text, a single line, that is a multi-line text box. Change the email is also required, the regular expression validator control. Error message is the name required. Name required. The foreground color is the right color. Text display the message is strict assign, and control to validate property is to validate the name text box. Okay, again, similarly, again, now you are watching to in the next video tutorial. Thank you very much for the first part of your comment box.